I am looking for the 2700X for this build, but, well, this one might be a little difficult to find. Okay, I see. Oh, there's a Ryzen box, but that one looks like it doesn't have a cooler, so I'm gonna guess this one is for first-gen Ryzen. Yeah, pretty sure first-gen Ryzen. Oh, there's a box. That one's a big one, so that one holds a cooler. That might have what I need. Oh, look, it says 2700X. Except it's empty. Yep. Oh, hello, Ryzen APU build. You're looking a little disassembled. We got some, oh, hey, look, a snack. I'll come back to you later. Okay, I think maybe it's in one of the builds we're using right now. Oh, Intel. Nope. Oop, this one might be promising. This one looks like a Wraith Prism cooler. I'm not sure if anyone's using it, so... Hey, Gordon, where's the 2700X? Hey everybody, Elena here from PC World. I am... Hey everyone, Elena here from PC World. I am bringing you a new project we're trying out. It's going to be a vlog about a PC build. So I've been thinking of building a streaming box just for funsies, because why not? There's a lot of parts out there with a lot of cores, so I may as well take advantage of that. So unlike our normal live builds where, you know, we talk about the parts and then we actually build it in front of y'all live and then we have a postmortem, we are actually gonna be doing this in a lot more detail. I have never streamed to Twitch before, so you're gonna be with me on this entire journey of picking parts, putting it together, seeing how it does in benchmarking, and most importantly, what the heck I'm gonna be doing to actually stream, like what software I'm gonna be using, what is the best way to actually handle like rapid fire chat if there are a bunch of people trying to talk at me while I'm looking at a camera, trying not to look like a deer in headlights. So you'll get to see all of it. Right now we're gonna go straight to the part picking, so let's go over to my desk and see what I grab. And I'm done picking parts. That took a little bit longer than I was anticipating, but you know, in theory, if I was to build this for myself, I would be looking at it for a long time, so wanted to get it just right. So what did I pick? Okay, so CPU. I'm going with a 2700X, which may seem like overkill, but again, I've never done a streaming box, and I know that some streamers actually have two whole separate systems altogether just because of how taxing it can be. And since I'm planning to do it all from one box, I felt like there's no reason for the CPU to be a potential bottleneck. I could have gone with 2700, but I have to admit that Wraith Prism cooler kind of tipped me over. I guess I'm willing to pay what, like $40 extra for that thing. So here we are. Motherboards, just a basic Gigabyte Micro ATX B350 board. Although this one does have slots for four DIMMs on the board, so I don't feel like I'm really giving that much up versus ATX, and this way if I want to I can still build small form factor, which is really something I love to do in general. Memory, I'm going with 16 gigs. Again, probably not necessary. I probably could get away with 8 gigs, but again, because I'm putting everything into one box, I just want to make sure there's no potential for, you know, things getting bottlenecked anywhere. Going with G-Skill, 16 gigs of DDR4 3000 speed memory. Storage, I went with an M.2 drive, which should be compatible with this motherboard, and I went with a Western Digital Black NVMe drive, 250 gigs, a little expensive, but it's on our list for one of the best SSDs out there, so I figured it's on sale, might as well. So video card, I went with a GTX 1070. I'll probably be streaming at, 1080p at most, but if I am thinking of this as something that I would actually build for myself, then I would like the option to game at 25 by, you know, 14 or 25 by 16. So splurged a little on that. Prices haven't come down as much as I would like them to, so yeah. And then the case. The case that I spent so much time on. I finally chose an NZXT S340, partially because it has really, looks like it has great cable management, the layout's really nice, I like that shroud, but perhaps most importantly and most shallowly, it comes in a color scheme that I like, which is a white and a purple. And again, if I have to stare at this a lot, I do want it to be something attractive and not necessarily something where I think, yeah, I guess I kind of cheaped out on that. And then finally, power supply. I went with the EVGA gold certified 650 watt power supply. So a little bit of a splurge. It's a modular power supply, so I expect Gordon to fight me on this one. All in all, before rebates, which you know, maybe me, I will file, but if I was just to, you know, take this as is out the door, it'd be about $1,200. That's where I think I'd be comfortable spending on a build like this, so it's still within budget. Although me being me, I definitely would like to get the price down if I could through sales. Once I get all the parts in, I think we're gonna do an unboxing video so you can kind of see my rendition of adult child reacting to Christmas in June. I guess we're almost in June. We may even try to see if I fit in the case box again, but no guarantees. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, you should definitely check out the postmortem video for our RGB build. Just saying. Otherwise, stick around, we'll have some fun stuff for you.